Hello everyone! Today's guide will be an arcane art skill build for the Revelation Online Spirit Shaper. This is a PvE healing skill build and only my personal opinion. Feel free to tell us yours in the comment section. I am open for new ideas. In the description you can find the links to the skill builds to see them in bigger size for yourself. I have to mention that on higher level you can get skill books that unlock extra paths, so some of the paths are not seen here, only the basics that can be obtained by everyone. Also a tip as a main healer, forget the action combat and switch to tap targeting if you want to be a decent healer. I made separate builds for level 49, 59, 69 and 79. Your first and most important skill is Falling Sakura. This heals an ally target and allies close to the target. This is your most used and most important skill. It has relative small cooldown, so you can use it all the time. You can also move while casting, that makes things easier. But you can't jump, don't forget that. By putting 2 points into the first line, you can increase its healing effect by 10%. If you need more combo skill point generation, you could spend your skill points into the middle line, but I think the healing bonus is more useful. Also, the fifth line could be very useful because it gives the target damage reduction. If you think it heals enough, you should switch to that. Green Vines. This would be your main area healing skill. It has small cooldown, you can spam it all the time. It heals your whole party. Don't be fooled by the effect, it has a big range, it will reach everyone, don't worry. By putting 2 points into the first line, you can increase its healing by 10%. The last line would dispel the negative effects, but on 49 I don't think it's that important. I would spend some points on it on higher level. Moonlight Herald. This is a channeled skill, it heals ally over 3 seconds. By putting 2 points into the first line, it will give you 10% more healing. And by putting 1 point into the second line, it will give you more combo skill points. The skill has a relative small range, so you might want to increase that by putting 1 point into the last line. If you think the range is fine, you should put that point on the combo skill point increasement, because you need those combo skills. Note that this skill heals only one target. Spirit Shell. It shields friendly target and absorbs incoming damage. This skill has a low cooldown, so you can place it on 2 targets at the same time if they don't get hit hard. That's why increase the absorption percent by putting 2 points into this spot. It will increase the absorption by 20%. Essence of Spring. It heals alive for 10 seconds and can be stacked up to 3 times. This is your heal over time skill, or short, HOT. You should always keep the stacks on the tank. If you have time, spread the skill one by one to all allies and stack it up slowly, except for the tank should have all the stacks right away. This build will increase the healing effect by 20%. Plus, your overall healing will increase with 30% with each stack. It will also give you 10% more points to the combo resource regenerations. And increases magical and physical defense with each stack by 2%. Falling Sakura. If you have Essence of Spring on your target, with this build you will get 5% more healing from it. Also, you will get a buff that reduces the incoming physical damage by 10% for 5 seconds. This is why I said you should always keep the Essence of Spring on. Green Vines. There is also a different method spreading your HOT by putting points into the top second spot. If you do this, when you use Green Vines, it will spread the essence text onto the allies. Because I have put only 2 points into it, it can only spread 3 stacks. Had to use my points for more important things. Moonlight Herald. As you can see, I have changed some things from the level 49 version. That is because from this level I think you will need more AoE heals. Of course, opinions differ and also it depends on how much the occultist helps. I decided to put 3 points to the top line because it makes the basic skill an AoE skill and heals the allies within 10 meters by 50% of the initial effect. I think this could be very useful than getting faster combo resource. Spirit Shell. More defense is always good, so by adding 2 points it will give the target in the bubble 20% more physical defense. Essence of Spring. With these extra 2 points, it will give the skill the ability to add 2 more stacks of essence to the target, 2 stacks altogether. This is very useful if you use the spreading with green vines, because in the level 69 build, I gave it the ability to spread 4 stacks. Falling Sakura. As you can see, Falling Sakura got many new points, because this is your most used kill. I had to sacrifice 3 points because I wanted to reach the cooldown reductions and the casting time reduction. This skill has a bit annoying global cooldown, so it is a big change if I reduce it. With this, the cooldown is reduced by 14 and the casting time is reduced by 1 second. I think this makes a huge difference. Also, it will give you more resource generation by 20%, and slowed, stunned, knocked down targets will receive 10% more healing. It's like you got a whole new spell. Green Vines. You can see here what I talked about earlier. It got the ability to spread 4 Essence of Spring stacks instead of 3. Also, the cooldown is reduced by 20%, and that is a big help. And you gain 20% more combo resource. Of course, I kept the 100% dispel point. Fettering. This is your basic resurrection skill. Now that you have more points to spend, I would recommend reducing the mana cost and cooldown of your resurrection skill. People in harder dungeon will die more often. Of course, we don't want that. You would want to go with skilled people, but most likely your allies will keep dying in the beginning. This will reduce the mana cost with 50% and the cooldown by 30%. Moonlight Herald. I am reducing the cooldown again by 20%. For that, I needed to put 2 points for resource gaining, and by adding 3 points to the end of the top line, I get a buff from using the skill. It will increase my healing power by 6% for 5 seconds. Essence of Spring. The skill gained many new bonuses. I focused my points here on reducing the incoming damage. Like this, each stack will increase the physical and magical defense by 3%, and if the target gets a critical damage while the HUD is on, it will get a buff for 5 seconds that reduces the incoming damage by 20%. This buff has a 90 seconds cooldown, unfortunately. Also, by using the Essence of Spring, it has 50% chance of reducing the cooldown of green vines by 1 second. I also increased the range by 3 and removed the resource gaining. Falling Sakura. Not many changes here, I only increased the range by 3. Also, no changes for green vines and feathering. Moonlight Herald gained 2 points for increasing range by 5. Sanctification. This will turn you into a spiritual form, a fox, for 8 seconds and gives you new skills. While healing, I usually don't use this form too much, only if I am preparing myself for an incoming CC skill, but by putting 2 points onto the top, it gives me 10% more skill damage or healing after I exit the form. If I need more heals, I will just turn into a fox for 1 second and turn back to a human right away. This skill is also useful if you have to run away fast. Spirit Shell. With this build, You not only increase the absorption, but it will increase the incoming healing by 30%. Also, the resource gaining is increased and the cooldown is reduced by 20%. Thank you for watching. I hope this skill build has helped you to make a good healing build. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section or on my Facebook page. Take care. Bye!